Hi and welcome to this RipEx tutorial, where I will explain how to configure a full duplex point-to-point link. Before guiding you through the configuration, I will briefly describe this type of connection and list scenarios where it is typically used. The RipEx to full duplex link behaves like a transparent L2 bridge. A full duplex link allows traffic to be transferred in both directions simultaneously and minimizes delays in communication. It can be established within a non-line of sight environment. Please note that this kind of application requires full RipEx 2 and cannot be practically achieved with RipEx 2E. Many types of communication use full duplex point-to-point configuration because any IP or serial transparent links benefit from long-range, high-speed communication and low latency. Typical uses in power distribution are for goose messaging, cell mirrored bits, and point-to-point backbones in advanced metering infrastructure. Full duplex links are also useful for endless connections between digital mobile radio base stations for voice over IP communications. A full duplex link is completely transparent and uses a frequency pair. It can offer a combined total speed of 3.4 megabits. Raycom offers a 19-inch rack mount that can include all the required accessories such as power source and duplexer in a convenient and easy to install package. And of course, a full duplex setup offers all standard RipEx 2 features like advanced security and support of SCADA protocols. When installing in the field, it is important to keep at least 80 decibels of isolation between the two frequencies. To achieve this, we recommend the use of a duplexer, passband filters that allow a transmitter and receiver to use a single antenna. A duplexer isolates the transmitter from the receiver and enables RipEx 2 to receive and transmit simultaneously without interference. As I stated, isolation requirements for a simultaneous operation are 80 dB. Without a duplexer, separate antennas for transmitting and receiving would be required, and these antennas would have to be spaced more than 30 meters apart in order to provide the required isolation. The duplexer can be mounted externally or inside the rack chassis. Now, let's get started. All you need are two RipEx units, a device to configure the setup, and a few minutes of your time. For full duplex point-to-point operation, both units must be in bridge mode. This requires both Ethernet IP addresses to be within one subnet. Be careful when configuring the frequency pair. One frequency will be used for data transmission from the first unit and the other for data transmission from the second unit. If you are conducting bench tests, it is sufficient to attach dummy antennas to both RX and TX-RX antenna ports. As I mentioned earlier, in the field, the use of passband filters, also known as duplexers, is the only practical solution. Connect to your first unit. Since we are working with transparent link, we strongly recommend using USB to Wi-Fi or USB to Ethernet adapters to shield the link from unwanted transmission from your operating system. Go to Settings, Interfaces, Radio, set mode to bridge, and communication mode to full duplex. Now, we will set the radio parameters. Frequencies, RF power, channel spacing, and occupied bandwidth limit must all be set as stated in the license you obtained from your regulatory office. Sometimes, modulation is also a part of the license. Since we're using a duplex connection, RX and TX frequencies are different. I will set 420 MHz for TX and 410 MHz for RX. Antenna configuration is automatically set to dual because communication mode was set to full duplex. In my example, I set modulation type to QAM and modulation to the maximum 256 QAM. RF power to the minimum of 20 dBm as recommended for lab tests. Channel spacing to the most typical 25 kHz and occupied bandwidth limit of 25 kHz as well. We leave forward error correction off. When you activate this feature, it will decrease the possible data throughput, but the reliability will increase. A quick side note, wider channel spacing and higher modulation produce a higher data speed. If you want to achieve the maximum speed, set modulation type to QAM, modulation to 256 QAM, channel spacing to 300 kHz and leave forward error correction off. Now let's switch to Ethernet. Set the IP address and mask to 192.168.1.1/24 and select radio and all Ethernet ports you wish to be connected into the bridge. That is all you need to set for the basic test. Go to Changes screen and review configuration. If everything looks good, click Send Configuration. Wait until the changes are made and log out. Configuration of Unit 2 is the same. You only need to set different Ethernet address, like 192.168.1.2/24, and switch RX and TX frequencies. You can verify the connection by using ICMP ping from the Diagnostics menu. As you can see, the round trip time is very fast, less than 20 milliseconds. The variance in response time is almost zero, which is also an important parameter. For more complex tests, run some iPerf throughput test or simulate your application. Thank you for watching this RIPEX tutorial. If you need any more information, feel free to comment here on YouTube or get in touch with our amazing technical support team via our website. Also, please subscribe to this channel to stay up to date with our upcoming tutorials. Thank you and have a great day.